everyone. Welcome to Technique Tuesday, a bit delayed, but I'm really excited to show you some tricks and tips with doing binding.
Yay!
It's one of my favorite things to do, and everybody looks at me like I'm nuts, but I have a few things that I think that will be of interest to you and will make binding a little easier. Now, I'm going to warn you, if you are a true quilter and must use that four-letter word to finish the binding on the back, that H-A-N-D word, just turn the video off now. For the rest of us, I'm going to go ahead and get started. I've brought a couple of pieces with me. These are a couple of the new beautiful fill stitches that are
in the upgrade if you have
an original Luminaire or Solaris, and they are in the Luminaire and Solaris too. So one of the things that I always tell people is do not ever start at the corner when you do binding. You want to start in the middle somewhere. And we're going to join our binding at the end and do a miter seam there as well. In order to make that happen, you have to have at least 8 to 10 inches. So I'm going to just sew here and then just around the corner. So I'm going to leave this open so that I can miter my corners together. And this one has some unusual corners on it. They aren't a straight degree, 45 degrees like these are. They are kind of at a slope. So the process is the same. It just may look a little bit different to you. So I'm going to start by finding my center here. I'm just going to pinch there. And then I have to leave my excess of binding there. And then I'm going to actually start sewing down here. I'm going to go a little further because I always end up with a piece mark right in the curve. So I won't do that. Now, today I'm going to show a 1/2 inch binding. And I have been using leftover pieces of another project that are complementary colors. And I'm loving how that looks on a quilt or something. It looks just a little bit different. So I'm going to start down here. And if you're using your digital dual feed walking foot, which you should be for something like this, I am going to be on stitch 102.
What?
Okay. Oh, machine was balking at us. And then I'm going to mirror image it all the way over to the right needle position. If I put the edge of my fabric and binding right smack against the edge of my foot, that is an exact 1/2 inch seam. And the important thing is to mark the 1/2 inch so you know when you're supposed to stop. So I do this quite a bit, so I'm pretty good at guessing where
eyeballing it.
Yeah, let me put all my little features on. Oh, that part's the only one I need right now, I guess. Right. So I'm gonna put my foot down. And I'm going to begin to stitch. I have the stitch priority on. So that means that whatever I start with is what it's going to stop with, no matter what I put. So I'm coming up to the my 1/2 inch. I'm going to stop. And then I'm going to lift the foot and I'm going to pivot out to the point. That's going to give me a nice, sharp miter. And I'm going to cut the thread. The next thing I'm going to do is I am going to fold this to where it gives me an angle that's compatible with the corner here. If I was up at the top, it would be a straight 45 degrees and then over. But this isn't quite the same kind of corner. And then I'm going to come back down. So it's a little bit different shape. But it still is going to work. And I am always, no matter what, I always end up with piecing in the places where I'd least like to have it. So now I'm going to come back over to this side. I'm going to put the foot down and I'm going to keep with my 1/2 inch seam allowance. And the same thing's going to happen when I get here. I want to stop at a 1/2 inch right smack at the point there. Thank you. And then I'm going to pivot and I'm going to sew out to the point and cut. And then I have to, again, get some extra fabric here because I need it to turn. So essentially what I'm doing is just keeping the shape of the point that I'm working with on these. So you can see that this kind of, if I go straight up, I'm going to hit the center point here. And the same thing, if I go straight up, I have, it's parallel with the point. I'm going to flip. Again, I'm just going to put the foot down and start to sew. And again, I have to, you know, stop at about a half inch so that I can, and look at this, treats today. Every single corner is going to be at where I pieced it.
That's so exciting though.
Isn't it though? So it's exciting for you.
It's so exciting for me because it's going to look so good.
All right. So it's right on the seam there. And pivot out. So what it does when you pivot out is it tacks this part down that's actually going to be underneath, that's going to hold your miter on the front. All right, so here we go. This again, and this again. All right, so if you look here, you can see that my V, which is right there, is right smack in the same position. So I'm just leaving enough extra that's the shape of the point that I'm working with. Put down. So now I'm going to come up to a traditional curve up here where I'm going to turn the corner, and that one's going to look a little bit not so scary, I guess would be a good term for it. So I'm going to stop at a half inch because that's my seam allowance. I cut my binding for this 2 1/8 of an inch. Traditionally, I would really only need a 2 inch for a half inch seam allowance, but it really depends on the batting that you're using and how thick it is. So the extra 1/8 of an inch I allow kind of allows for the batting being a little bit thicker. So now here's my traditional just 45 degree angle. So I'm coming to the end. I'm going to fold it up and out. So I have that 45 degree angle. Flip, fold it back, and start again. So I have like this, you can see where I have my miter right here in what I folded. Come back down. Right against the edge of my foot. And I'm just barely going to round the corner here because that's not even going to give me a whole 8 to 10 inches. And you'll see when I go to miter it why you need that extra 8 to 10 inches. So normally when I do this, I have an iron and an ironing pad on my right so that I can press as I go. Today I'm working with a little bit, it's on my left, which already seems odd to me. It's funny how we get used to doing things in the same way all the time.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to do the pivot. Sew straight out to the end, to the point. Now, again, I'm just going to round the corner for this because I'm going to leave that rest of it open so that I have room to do my miter. I'm going to pass the whole corner and I'm going to cut my thread. Okay, so anyone that knows me knows I hate math. I don't do math. I don't like math and I'm not good at math. But with this, it's really easy. However wide your strip was that you cut, in this case, 2 1/8 of an inch, that is the overlap that you need to miter the corner or miter the binding at the end. So I'm going to finger press this. So I've got my 45 degree angle. Now, if I come over, I've already crossed my two. Let me get some of this off. I didn't bring scissors. Scissors behind. Oh, here they are. Here we go. Let me get some of this out of the way. All right. So I've got to the end, and I'm going to flip up just like I did around the corners. I'm going to flip this up at 45 degrees and finger press it. Now, if I was at home, I would actually press it, because it gives you a nice clean line to follow. And then I'm going to take this one, and I'm going to just put it over the top. And the amount of extra that I need is equal to the 2 1/8 inch, which was the width of my binding. So I'm gonna fold it over there and just cut it off. I am that sure that it's going to work. The moment of truth. And I'm going to put a clip here so it stays. And I'm going to put a clip here so it stays. And then I'm going to clip this out of the way. That's why you need the extra 10 inches. So with that, you can move this out of the way when you go to sew that miter. Just like when you're putting your strips together, it keeps it out of the way, makes it easier for you to get it done. All right, so here's the connection. There's my finger pressed seam that I can see right there. There's my corner. Now for this, I'm going to go back to a center needle position. So I'm going to go to 1.04. Make sure that the corner is underneath there. Drop my needle down. And just sew down where I finger pressed. And when you do this, your eyes should always be where you're going, not at the needle. Just like when you drive the car. Okay, so now when I let this loose, my miter is exactly the size, the length that I need to do that.
Oh my God.
I'm going to go ahead and press this. See, this is why I like doing it. It's just, there's tricks. Press this open. And anytime I press, I always use a pressing block. I know, or clapper, or whatever you want to call it. I always do, because you'll always get a much flatter seam with a block. And when you turn it, the same thing. It'll always look better if you press it with a block.
Oh, yeah,
it's just really flat and open. Yeah. So I'm going to go ahead and finish up my seam.
That was
now.
Like a magic trick.
It was. It was a sleight of hand.
A magic trick.
All right, so my miter's complete. Oh, look at that. Was that a magic trick?
That is a magic trick.
I thought it might be a magic
trick.
That
is so cool.
So with my, I'll have some little bit of differences in my coloring there. I love these. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to press everything flat. And I'm telling you, the block is...
life-changing.
Yeah, it really is for stuff like this. I use a shorter one when I press inside the hoop to do in the hoop projects, because especially in the hoop bags, because you don't get to press a second time once they're closed. All right, see how flat that is?
That is so flat.
It just doesn't, you know, it's magical.
Literally.
It's the wooden unicorn.
Oh my gosh. The wooden unicorn.
So kind of flat.
That's so crazy that the difference really that it makes. Yeah.
Yeah, it's the wood absorbs the heat. All right.
Oh, wow. Look at that. It's perfect.
So essentially what we did is allowed enough fabric to create that miter. Maybe the blue would be easier to see than the purple. And based on the shape of the point. So we just allowed it to have an extra enough fabric there that we could actually have a mitered corner.
Wow.
So now I'm just going to press that down. And again, press it, hit it with the block. I dropped my mini iron this week.
Mm-hmm. And sad. So,
yes, it is sad because
that's tragic.
I always have that mini iron by my machine and it just like went, nope, not working anymore. All right, I've got that pretty well pressed out. And now the next thing I'm going to do, quilt purists, please leave now. The next thing I'm going to do is put steam a seam on the back so that I can, the easiest way for me, I'm not a quilter, so I didn't have any rules that I had to break because I didn't know what they were anyway. But the easiest way I think to do binding is to use the technology that's in the machine that you bought, because that's why you bought it, right? So I'm going to do one edge at a time. And I steam a seam the whole edge right on the 1/2 inch seam line because that's where I want the stick to be. Because I want to be able to try and keep my my stitching to where I'm catching all of the back. All right, so there's that. Okay, trick with the steam a seam, if it always ravels for you, is pull up.
Like straight
instead
up.
Of pulling across, pull straight up. All right, so then what I'm going to do is do this, fold it. And what's nice about this is you have the extra 1/8 of an inch. If you took too much of a seam on one side or not enough on the other, what you fold underneath but when you turn might vary, but the 1/2 inch that you get at the end will be the same.
Oh, that is amazing.
So to turn the corner, I'm going to go all the way out. So I do one whole straight section at a time. And before I steam a seam it, I always double check.
Could you try again?
Stop. Series. Piping in. All right, so see, I'm making my miter there because that's going to be the miter when I turn the corner in the back there. All right, I'm going to give it a check from the front just to make sure. See, I have some extra here, so I'm going to pull a little bit of that to the back and maybe take a little bit more of a seam allowance underneath that I fold down. Let's see how that looks now. Better. All right, I'm going to start at the edges because I want that really sharp point there. I'll move the clip as I go. Turn it over because I'm going to sew from the front. All right, turning the corner. Same thing. I'm going to do the seam seam first, all the way to the end. You need to get some seam seam in that corner. This iron feels so big.
I love my mini iron.
I do too.
I don't know what I would do without it.
I have a bunch of the ones that were... I have one that actually was my grandmother's. It still has the black cord, funny looking cord on it.
Oh, wow.
But it's tiny. And it just... All right, so I'm just going to pull... Rather than pulling back like this, I'm just pulling straight up. Hey. All right. Let's start in the middle first. All right, so when I get here, I want to work that in to that point and bring that point around.
Ooh la la.
I love the sound effects,
Jonah. Look at that corner. Look at her.
Oh. So now we're coming down to a funky corner down here. So we'll
That's
see how
so
we
exciting.
Go. Yeah. So I'm the girl that says fear no zipper, and now I'm telling you fear no corner. There's always a method. All right, so I can move these now because it's steam seamed. It's not going anywhere. And I'm going to do the same thing here. I want to make sure that I pull the excess out and make sure that that bottom part gets stuck down. And, of course, I'm going to check the front first. This looks good. This looks a little sloppy. So now I can tuck just a little bit more of that underneath there. Again, I want to keep my... I want to keep my point. And I'm going to do that first.
So you're starting at the most important corner first.
Yeah.
And then working your way down. Mm-hmm. That is awesome.
I start clipping in the center so that I can evenly distribute everything. And then...
That is so awesome. Look at it so far. It looks so good. I have so many, like, half-finished projects because I don't do binding.
Well, I told you.
Like, they're, like, almost done, but they're not really done. Maybe I'll go home and try this now.
You should.
I really should.
Because you'll have a video.
Now I can watch the video.
I've watched your videos. That's how I
now
got...
Now I can watch
now,
the
Now
show.
You can watch this one. I think that's the greatest thing is we all learn from each other.
Yes, 100%. And look how perfect.
Yeah, the turn on the corner is really good.
Oh, so good.
But I know they're waiting for me to turn that one because it's different.
Because it's
I know
so different.
Yeah, I know these ladies.
They're I think this is like the perfect sample for binding because you have so many
different corners. Yeah. This one came up, this point, like this here came up because we had it in one of the Janine Babbage classes.
Oh,
I
yeah,
did.
Her
yeah.
wall hanging.
Yeah, the wall hanging one. So the other thing you can do if it's short, you know, if the area is short, is you can just warm it up a little bit before you put the steam seam on it, and then the steam seam sticks better. I want a little bit, but I can't cover the whole thing because that's going to be...
Sticking out.
Yeah.
I love that steam seam tears so easily, so you don't mm-hmm. even have to fuss with it.
You do kind of want to let it cool a little bit before you begin to peel, though. And then again, I am lifting. I'm going to get my finger underneath it, and I'm lifting. I'm pulling this way. Not
straight
pulling.
Up.
Straight up. And go slow, especially if it's not cooled yet. Right? So let's go over here because I have to do this corner. I'm going to do that first.
and look at that. So cute. They just meet up so perfectly.
Yeah. It's like match.com, right?
Literally. That's exactly what it is. They were meant to be together.
All right. So we've got our nice point there. We've got our nice point there.
Oh my God. It looks amazing.
We're going to now press.
Is anyone else just sitting here being like, oh my God, you make it look so easy?
It is. Don't be scared. Remember what your parents used to tell you? You got to feel the fear and work through it?
Yes.
It's okay to be afraid. It's not okay to be paralyzed.
Yes. Which right now with binding, I'm paralyzed.
All right, so we're getting close.
Yay!
Our front's looking good. Oh, we got some nice corners there. We got some nice miters on weird corners. Because I know this was the one you wanted me to do. I know you.
You know our ladies.
I do.
And thank you for all the reminders that we didn't post our Technique Tuesday on Tuesday. We had no Patrick, so it was a little difficult getting time to film. Oh, don't burn yourself.
I did already. Oh, I do
no!
It. That's why I like a mini iron. All right, we're almost done on the home stretch.
Woo!
I'm going to try from the other side.
Is it still hot?
Yeah, it's still hot, and it's a short piece, so. So to me, the steam seam is more persnickety than the binding. Come in here and do this corner first. I love that turned out.
Yeah, that is a really, really neat spot. It's like perfect.
Yeah, when it's, yeah it's really so pretty perfect. Fun. I didn't know if it was going to work or not, but I'm glad I tried it. Looking good here.
Woo!
I really don't need to clip it, but I like to clip it until it cools because that way the steam machine has a chance to really stick. And then before I go to the machine, I'll take it and I'll do it one more time.
One
all
really
the way
good
around.
Press.
Yeah, one good press all the way around. Okay, we're at the home front.
Ooh!
We're gonna have two corners left to put on there.
It looks so fantastic.
I love this purple. I love these purple colors.
I know, like the jewel tones, it's so pretty. Yeah. Like purples and blues and teals.
We both seem to be navigating towards those the last couple of days.
Yes.
Huh? Must be because of the gloomy weather, huh?
Yeah. I think they're also Jeannie's favorite, so maybe we just see them a lot.
Oh, that could be.
They're really nice colors, though. They work really well together.
All right. Pulling this up. Right. You know, middle first.
Here. No, I left him a message saying they're not back on.
All right, there's that one corner down.
Look at that corner. It looks so good.
Coming up on the last one.
Oh, hold on. The camera is trying to focus on your hand. Okay, there we go.
All right. So from the middle. Miter corner.
Oh, it's so beautiful.
And the last corner.
Oh my God, so, oh my God, this is so exciting to see, like, it's almost done.
It's almost there, huh? It won't take me very long now. That is so
crazy.
So I used bright orange thread when I was actually sewing this so that you could all see it. But when I actually do my stitch that I like, it's going to be with monofilament thread in the bobbin and in the top. So I'm going to give it one good last press all the way around.
Make sure everything's nice and flat.
You can definitely see where that helps.
Yeah, it really does.
You look at that one. That one's pressed, but that one's really pressed. So you can see how it is now. And we did press it. I mean, we pressed it when we stuck it down.
Extra press makes such a difference.
Okay, the stitching moments. Wake up. Wakey, wakey, machine. All right, so I'm going to take off my orange, and I am going to put on my monofilament. So we'll see if this luminaire likes threading monofilament any better than mine does, because mine hates it, but I always give it at least one try. She likes it.
Yay!
This is going to come out. This is going to go in.
And that's monofilament as well.
Monofilament, both top and bottom. And give myself a little. And then here's the key, ladies. You want to switch to a stitch in the ditch foot. And you really want that deep ditch, because that's what's going to make your stitching the most like the four-letter word stitching. All right, so I'm going to go to my favorite stitch that I love for this, and it is Q12.
That's under the quilting.
It's
folder.
Under the quilting, and I actually demoed on this machine last, so I had saved the stitch in this, so it's actually saved in my memory.
So
for
it's
me.
A width of 2.25 and a length of 3.
And a left-right shift. So let me reset the actual stitch to its original format. You have a left-right shift, and that allows you to put that seam in the ditch no matter what the stitch is. So this is my stitch as it came out. Oops. This is the stitch as it comes out when you touch it. First of all, I need it to go that way. And then I want the length a little bit longer, and I want the width just slightly wider. All right? But here's, I don't know if you can zoom in on where the needle is, Shauna.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is if I were to do needle down now, I'm off from where the ditch foot is. So what I need to do is I need to use my left-right stitch to bring my needle over to the ditch. And on a half an inch seam, it's usually left-right 1.25.
So that's the magical setting.
That's a magical setting. That one's saved in all my machines because on a half inch seam allowance, my eyes are now going to be here. I have to not pay attention at all to the needle because it's already been set. All I need to do is watch the ditch. The blade needs to stay in the ditch.
And it's perfect.
Because we made it perfect.
God.
So I'm going to go all the way to the curve, and I'm going to slow down here because it's kind of thick. I want the blade to go over the top so I can kind of keep, and then when I come to the end there, I'm going to stop with my needle down, pivot.
Oh, and it's that easy? Of course it's that easy, Michelle. Of course you make it look that easy.
And again, I'm going to go all the way. I slow down when you come to the junctions here because you got a lot of fabric here, and see that? Could tend to grab some of it. So, and then again, I want to stop right at that, at the junction where I made the turn. And then if you're a pedal to the metal gal, once you've made the turn, have at it.
That is so amazing.
So with this, you have no pins in your way. You have no clips in your way.
Yeah, you don't even have to worry about a
thing.
This
is like being on the Autobahn with no traffic.
And it looks so smooth.
You're just watching here. Do not watch the needle. It's like driving a car.
You gotta look ahead.
You turn where your eyes look. So if my eyes are looking at the needle, I'm not watching where I'm going. Because it's a little blanket stitch, if you weren't perfect with your when you folded it over on the back, it doesn't matter because you have a little bit of a bite from that.